17 and a half. Well, could be 18, depending on how you count the dwarf woman. The dwarf woman. You were trying to figure out whether to count her as a full person. I think you oughta. The people hanging from the tree. 18 of them. Well, last I counted, anyway. Name's Adair. Though to the people around here, might as well be 19. Don't think I'd put you much higher than 22, 23 tops. You look like the sort that likes to get involved. Well, I was smoking over here, saw you staring at her. Twice I refilled my pipe. You never so much as blinked. Your mouth was so slack, I took you for a Radric at first. Careful, friend. Best not use that word round here. There'd be any number of Radric bootlickers within earshot. Ciphers, animancers, watchers. Same thing in the eyes of folks round here, Radric especially. They come to these parts all the time with their cures, preying on the desperate. None of them are who they claim to be. Of course, seeing you with that funny look, I'd be halfway inclined to believe you were having some kind of communion with that dwarf. Either case, maybe I'm not 19 after all. No offense. The town's had it in for me for a long time now. Only fellow who ever stuck up for me, well, he's number 18 up there. My headman on the farm. Used to be my captain during the war. We blew him up. Picked the wrong god. That's what it comes down to. Used to be a lot of Vaithas worshippers in Gilded Vale. That mess of rocks over there, there was a temple to him, to give you some idea. Then one day, somebody named Widewind shows up on Deerwood's doorstep. Says he's the living flesh of Aethys. Got an army with him. Suddenly, Aethys isn't so popular in these parts. My brother Woden and me, neither of us believed it. No way was that Aethys. He enlisted, then I did too. But, he didn't make it back. After the war, people took to punishing Aethys worshippers, accusing them of treason. Got real ugly, especially after the legacy started. Folks needed someone to blame. I was safe because I fought, but then this rumor starts that my brother, that he was on the wrong side. And I wasn't so safe anymore, until my headman stepped in and said they'd have to hang him to get to me. Seems that's no longer a concern. Of course, the townies don't do the hanging these days, but when Radric's men come, they got no problem doing the pointing. All right, then. Guess I'll do some sightseeing. Long as you're not the one picking the sights.
You're from Gilded Vale? Then you're close to home.
Close can mean a lot of things.
Surely you'll go back when this is all over.
Dunno. Guess that all depends.
The other missionaries say you have been neglectful of your duties. Oh? And what troubles you? You have been an apt student, and your convictions have inspired those around you. May I ask what has changed to make you feel this way? Trials of faith can be without mercy, separating us from those we love, leaving no easy answers. You have failed no one. The gods would not ask you to abandon your family. It is your family that has failed you. Yet they do not allow you the same. They would have you trade your deepest beliefs for their affections. If you allow this, you will gain their acceptance, but lose their respect. Hold firm to your convictions. Continue your work. Believe in the power of the gods to reach all people. Your family will find them on their own. As long as you worship the gods, you will never be without family. You needn't choose between the two.
Well, whatever happens, at least we're out of that mud hole, Gilded Vale. I grew up in Gilded Vale.
Quaint. That's what I meant to call it.
No, you had it right.
God's damn that son of a cool. Want to run a down on its luck Valiant Trading Company? If you have more than half a brain, you could really do something with it. As long as you're willing to clean up a few bloodstains. Exactly. If I knew that, I'd be in a better mood. The only thing I know exactly is that Mestre Verzano is determined to wind up in a grave before the season turns.
Hail and well met.
Good day, stranger.
Thank you.
Hail, traveler.
Sagani, does your fox bite?
Yes.
Can I pet him anyway?
It's your hand.
I'm gonna pet him.
I wonder, Aloth, don't you ever feel curious about Isilmir's history?
Not even a little.
But think of... the opportunities! You could learn so much about the past.
There are some things I'm happy not knowing. You had 5 siblings?
That's right. Between the 6 of us, I don't think the house has known a single day's quiet. Of course, a little chaos makes it far easier to get away with mischief.
Yes, I can imagine that comes in handy.
Good day to you.
Well, well. Is this your last day among the living, Verzano? As if any of this were ever in my hands. The Republic's considered your business worth protecting based on its success. That success depended on cooperation with the locals, like House Domanel. You've lost that. And the favor of the Dukes. Even if you get out of this alive, they're done with you. The Dukes have more pressing interest in Defiance Bay than rescuing one merchant who threw himself overboard. Verzano, Verzano, why are you wasting your precious breath on me? My orders come through the ambassador and through the ambassador from people you should be honored ever gave a moment's thought to whether you live or die. You don't seem like the sort to petition the gods to keep him out of hell. So why not cry mercy to the one person in this room with the power to grant it? A hard fate, but not unwarranted. Do as you will. He's no longer my concern. Ah. It's done, then. You did the right thing. Verzano has no one to blame for this but himself. We gave him more than enough warnings, but he never listened. In any case, the embassy's entanglements with him have been cut, which also means that I'm free from Verzano's net of stupidity. You have my thanks. Whether you intended to or not, you've done the Valian Republics a service today in ridding us of you. I work closely with the embassy to protect our interests, but lately I think our gaze has been too narrow. You clearly have pursuits of your own in the city, but I think we could help each other out. If you're interested in doing some work for us. Officially, I mean. We can go together and I'll introduce you to the ambassador. Good. Maybe I can finally do something more worthwhile than playing nanny to merchants. The embassy is up in First Fires, southwest of the Ducal Palace. I don't know this castle's history, but I feel confident saying it must have seen better times.
See you when I see you.
Ambassador Agosti, I would speak with you on a matter of some urgency and great importance. Ambassador, I implore you to take a step back and look at this again. What is it the Dukes need of me, Ambassador? A Chosi, Ambassador. But won't this provoke the dear Woodens? Their country is falling apart, and we are already dividing up their trade alliances. Really? After that, you have nothing to say. Of course, Ambassador. Attend to the Unamenfart as soon as I am able to travel to Twin Elms. Could have gone better. Could have gone worse. Not that you helped put up much of a fight. Enough wisdom for both of us. Now, I just need to find out how to get to Twin Elms before the Ambassador loses his patience. I wish I knew.